friends and welcome to Uma's Kitchen. Gujiyas make an important snack during the Diwali season, but of course, they are wonderful to make and eat any time of the year as a sweet snack as well. They have a crispy outer cover made with all-purpose flour and semolina and have a filling of coconut and sugar. Traditionally, the filling is made in two different ways, one using the dry coconut and second using the freshly grated coconut. But here we are going to use the freshly grated coconut today to prepare the filling. So first, let us start with the ingredients. For the filling you will need sugar 1 and 1/4 of a cup, fresh grated coconut 2 cups, cardamom powder according to your liking, rice flour 1.5 teaspoons and raisins about 30 to 35. For the cover you will need all-purpose flour 3/4 of a cup, semolina 3/4 of a cup, oil 3 tablespoons for the dough for the cover and more for deep frying the gujiya. Salt just a small pinch and milk 6 tablespoons for soaking the semolina and 4 tablespoons more for making the dough for the cover. For making the cover, let us start by soaking the semolina in milk. We have to keep adding little milk at a time. You have to cover all the grains of the semolina. So add maybe about 1 or 2 tablespoons at a time and then mix it together. And keep adding more till all the grains of the semolina are fully soaked in milk. For a rough idea, I am using about 6 tablespoons of milk to soak all the semolina. Once all the grains are nicely soaked in milk, then cover it and keep it aside for about 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, I am transferring this to another kneading bowl where we can prepare the dough. And now to this, add all the all-purpose flour. Add just a pinch of salt. Now this oil, which I have already measured to be 3 tablespoons, I am going to heat it up. When it is nicely hot, then add it to the semolina and all-purpose flour mixture. To this, again add milk little at a time and we have to knead this into a semi-hard dough. The dough should neither be very soft nor very dry and hard. Again, to give you an idea, I used about 4 more tablespoons of milk to get this consistency. So let us cover this dough and keep it aside for about 15 minutes till we prepare the filling. For the filling, mix the coconut and the sugar in a pot. Turn on the gas, keep on medium. Mix everything together and allow the sugar to melt. Keep turning it around so that it gets evenly heated. After the sugar melts, we have to cook the coconut in the melted sugar. Keep turning it around, keep the flame on low to medium and allow it to cook for about 10 minutes. Now add the rice flour, raisins, and cardamom powder and mix everything together. Let it stay for 2 more minutes on low flame and then turn off the gas. Now allow the filling to cool completely, and to make it faster, I have spread it in a plate. Now divide the dough into small parts, each part about an inch big. Now roll each part between your palms and press to flatten. And now let us start making the gujiya. Now take one part of the dough at a time and start rolling it, make it into a circle as thin as possible. Now lift it up and give it a small pinch on one side. Place about a tablespoon of filling in the center. Now fold the dough to cover the filling and then tightly close the edge. Press firmly. And now use this special cutter to trim the edges and make a nice design along the edge. Remove the uneven border on the outside. Press firmly one more time. Make sure no openings are left so that the filling doesn't come out when you are frying them. And our gujiya is now ready for frying. Similarly, repeat with the rest of the dough. If you do not have the special cutter to trim the bhujia, there is another way to fold the edge in a beautiful way. Let me show you how. Start from one end of the edge, fold it inside and press it firmly. Pull out the next part in this way and then fold it inside. Again, pull out the next part and fold it inside. And you have to keep repeating it till you form a nice design along the edge of the gujia. So even if you do not have a cutter, you can make a nice design along the edge of the gujia. Although making this design on each and every gujia instead of trimming it takes a longer time, but it looks really very beautiful. And even if you do not have a cutter, you can make all gujia in this way. But always remember that as you keep making more and more gujias, keep them covered with a slightly damp cloth or a kitchen towel so that they do not dry out before frying. Similarly, repeat with the rest of the dough and the filling. And when a few gujia are ready, you can start frying them in small batches. Keep the gas on low medium and fry them till they are golden brown in color. Turn them around couple of times in between, and when they are slightly golden reddish in color, drain out the excess oil and remove them on a paper towel. Similarly, deep fry all the gujias once you have filled them, and remember to cool them completely before storing in an airtight container so that the crunchiness stays. So enjoy making this delicious sweet snack at home. Do not hesitate to post any questions or comments, and remember to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.